Hi guys, so now I'm going to add more resources to this bundle. So typically if we look into other code, I will just show you some other code, GitHub eevee.health. And then for example, we have bundles builder here. It's prescription bundle builder, prescription bundles builder here. And this bundles builder, it creates the bundle and then adds all the different kinds of things to the bundle. And now here you can see how this is done. And I will create some as an example. So let's start here with a patient. So let's copy this here and then add this here for the patient. And add this, create this method. Also import this patient. And now what you can do then is patient plus new patient. And now you have to fill this resource with the data from your PVS system. So this normally runs in your PVS system. There are also different kinds of similar libraries. So I think there's one called Firely, which is for .NET. And I'm quite sure there are also lots of other libraries that do similar work in other languages. And now let's go in the function here and see what the function is doing. So first thing, what the function is doing, it's setting a random ID to the patient. So let's do this. And let's import the UUID. Then next thing is that it's setting the profile to the KBV defined patient profile. So, and now let's also check out this profile here. So this is the profile. And here you can see some conditions on this patient profile. So for example, this patient can have up to three different identifiers. It can have the normal gesetzlichen Krankenversicherungsnummer, it can have the private Krankenversicherungsnummer, or it can have KV key. Actually, I have to admit, I don't know what this number is. I know that it's not mandatory because we created some profiles where it was skipped. But here you can always check what's necessary. Then you have the name. The name is a human name from the German base profile of the KBV. And you have the address, and the address, it's the normal Straßenanschrift and the Postfach. And now I'm just going to copy all this data from the example that we just had. So here, so this is the identifier. Let's just get the whole code and then I will just have some examples here. So this would be the Versicherungsnummer. So let's take one X12347. And also I have to get the identifier. So, and now let's get rid of this one here. Now I'm going to specify an example prefix, and I'm going to use myself as an example. And this is the prefix. So typically it's used for doctor, but in my particular case I don't have a doctor, so I'm going to put in my academical highest degree, which is a master degree, so mm.sc. Typically you don't do this, so this is not a part of the name, but I just want to use real data, and I don't want to fake a degree from a doctor, so therefore just using my master. So then my given name, it's Manuel, and then my last name is Blechschmidt. And you can see here that, there are some extension added. These extensions, they are based from based on the profile of, the KBV. So this is all what they require. And then this will be all joined. Then the birthday. So and this is the German format. This means it's first first the day, then the month, and then in the end the year. And there is get simple, so simple date format should be month, month, day, day, year, year, year. I'm not 100% sure. I think it's like this. System.out. Birthday, okay, and the city I'm living in, it's Berlin. The postal code, it's 129. Then the street name, it's Treusenstraße 7. And here again, street name, it's Treusenstraße. And the number is 7. So, and this is how you create a patient resource. And then for the bundle, what you do is you add this as an entry. So add entry, and I think you can you need some more things here. Let me just look this up. Yeah. So here are the entries, and let's see where the patient entries are. Here's the patient entry edit. So this is how the patient entries edit. Now let's run this whole thing again. Okay, so this now added all the things here. Let's see if, my birthday also worked correctly. Yeah, so my birthday, no, it didn't work correctly. I think that there was some issues with, uppercase. So let's try to do the MM in uppercase. Let's try this again. Let me just double check how this date format works. This is here in GitHub. Default, yeah, so, and actually this is the correct format. Like this. And now let's try this again. Okay, so now also the date is correct. So this date here, it's formatted in ISO 8601. This is the international standard how you should format a date. And also what we can do is for our parser, we can enable pretty print. Set pretty print true. And this will also show this JSON in a nice format. So here you go. And this is how you specify an person resource for the KBV profile. And the important thing are these profiles here, and also these systems and the extensions. And this is all shown on the Simplifier KBV page. Thanks a lot, and see you in the next video.